Okay. See, if you remember last class, we started with Swaranam. Okay. Now, what did we speak about Swaranam in the last class?
Mind place.
We spoke of mind, and mind was explained, or the mental symptoms of Swaranam was explained with a case. So, the idea of creating a case is we will remember Swaranam much better. Okay. A quick revision, what exactly you remember, we'll have a quick recall and then we'll continue with Swaranam. So, what are the mental symptoms of Swaranam? We spoke of the Swara, we spoke of the psychosis, and we also spoke of the syphilitic expression of Swaranam. You can either go systematically or randomly you can start giving out the symptoms of Swaranam. In any way. There is a lot of anxiety, yes, there is anticipation, and there is also stage fear, very good, correct, and there was also fear, fear of what? Fear of poverty. And what was the beauty in Swaranam? Though they are rich, though they have money, though the business is going on beautifully well, they feel they might go into loss. So this is a very characteristic symptom of Swaranam. Okay? Anything else? Fear of poverty, delusion.
Poor.
What was the delusion we had? Delusion is poor.
Poor.
Delusion of him being poor. And a lot of stage fear. Now how did we link the stage fear in Swaranam? At the level of delusion in Atha? Delusion feels laughed at or mocked at. That was at the syphilitic level. Under soric level, we see more of stage fear. This can get reflected, or if you start asking them, when you have stage fear, what happens? Why do you have stage fear? A Swaranam patient may come with an explanation, or he might feel that people will laugh or people might mock at it. Okay? And apart from fear of poverty, what else had in Swaranam? What were the remorse has very good. One of the top remedies for remorse, anxiety, conscience. Yes, good. So this was in short about Swaranam mind. Now this was the last slide. Okay. Now next 40 minutes, we will try to focus on three key areas of Swaranam. Okay. Now one is if you just look at the PPT there, the screen there. We will be talking of the sphere of action only. And we are also extending or we are going ahead. Sphere of action is what? Which part a remedy acts. We are going ahead and we are trying to understand what exactly it does acting on that particular part. This is what we call it as pathogenesis. Very good, pathogenesis. So sphere of action and pathogenesis. Very, very important. Okay. And apart from that, we will be talking about ailments from. And we will conclude the class with characteristic symptoms. So this is what I'll be doing for next few minutes. Now Swaranam, you all know it's a nosod. First nosod, proved by Dr. Hahnemann himself. And it was used, or it was proved using the discharges from the
Scabies
eruptions in the discharges that was taken, and then it was patentized and they started using Swaranam. A very deep acting remedy. When I say a deep acting remedy here under this heading, it means to say that Swaranam has action from head to toe. But we will look at those specific areas of Swaranam. Okay, we look at those specific areas of Swaranam where it has got predominant affinity. To start with, this is a remedy which has a very important action on the lymphatic system. See, and this beautifully gets reflected when we talk of characteristic symptom. See, sphere of action, pathogenesis will help us understand or will help us reason out the symptoms that are produced in drug flow. Okay? Now, here what you see is, you see a lot of acrid secretions. and you also see a lot of offensive discharges. Later part of the class, when I talk to you about the characteristic symptoms, you will realize why psoriasis has acrid discharges, why psoriasis has offensive discharges. You will get an idea. Okay? So this is one very important thing. And second area will be the central nervous system. As a final year student, you know, nervous system is a very vast topic. Anything can happen. But what happens in psoriasis, that is very important. Now before we go ahead, can you recall few remedies acting on the nervous system?
Ajanta,
very good, beautiful. Jalsi, ma'am, yes. Hypericum, okay. Now, hypericum, can somebody quickly comment? Hypericum is more of injury. Injury to the nerve. Good. Hypericum. Yes. Any other remedies?
Helleborus.
Zincum. Cuprum. Okay. Platina. A lot of remedies. Fine. And you should understand, each of the remedies that you have contributed will have a different action. Though it is acting on the same system, the results will be different. Okay. Now the question is, what will psoriasis do acting on the nervous system? Okay. Psoriasis mainly causes debility, mainly causes nervous prostration. Okay. So you don't see more of though you do have paralysis in psoriasis, it will cause more of weakness, nervous weakness. Okay. Quickly going ahead, another important area, respiratory tract. Okay. So what will psoriasis do? Again, it can be upper respiratory tract or the lower respiratory tract. Psoriasis acts and it causes mainly cough, or it can cause difficulty in breathing, dyspnea. Okay. We'll explore this in detail a little later. I'm just giving you some small hints. Small clues. Retain all these clues so that the next part will be very interactive. Okay. Now mucous membrane. Okay. And this is again a very important area. Mucous membrane in general. Okay. That will come up a little later. A mucous membrane pertaining to the GI or pertaining to the respiratory tract. So GI, ena bolo. You have already studied psoriasis, few of you here. So what could be the probable action of psoriasis on the GIT? Okay, very good, ulceration. So no issues, ulceration. Now the question is, can psoriasis cause ulceration? Which miasm is psoriasis predominantly? Predominantly is a psoriatic miasm. Okay, psoriatic miasm. So the manifestations are seen more here. Okay. So manas is ulcerations, no issues. But anything else that you can think of in psoriasis?
Involuntary.
Involuntary? JTL. So you know. So what definitely you have here in psoriasis is it will cause some changes in the appetite. Okay. And can somebody quickly tell me? What happens to the hunger part in psoriasis?
Unusual hunger.
Okay, that will come up in the characteristic symptoms. Yes, hunger. There can be small variation, small change you see in hunger. So, appetite, there can be some issues. I'll talk about appetite a little later. Now, another area, psoriasis. Even in practice, we have confirmed is a very important remedy for diarrhea. Diarrhea, or it can also be a very important remedy for constipation in infants. Constipation in infants, okay? Or diarrhea in general, diarrhea in anybody. Okay. So three areas we have spoken till now, or four areas. First was lymphatic system, very good. Second was CNS, and third was respiratory. Fourth to GI, and fifth we are talking about sebaceous gland. Okay. Sebaceous gland in particular or skin in general, UC Sorana Nakti. So again a white, yes. What exactly can it cause acting on the skin? Acting on the skin, what exactly can psoriasis? It can, yes, very good. It can give rise to acne. It can give rise to eruptions. Okay, it can give rise to inflammatory disorders. Okay, eczema, all those things. Right. So, sebum secretion in psoriasis will be increased. The sebaceous secretions will be increased, and there can also be dirty eruptions or eczema on skin. So the last point I want to highlight here is we spoke of mucous membrane in particular, GAE respiratory, and I am talking to you mucous membrane in general. Okay, it causes inflammation. Okay, so this is the first objective that we had set for today. I told you we'll be talking of, you know, sphere of action, and we'll be talking of pathogenesis. Deep acting nosode acts everywhere, but I have given you few specific affinities where psoriasis can act. Okay, any questions here? Any questions? All of you are clear? You go ahead. No questions. Fine. See, no questions means I will be reviewed. There are questions, then yeah. Anyway, now we'll talk of the second component that we had planned for today. Ailments from. As a final year student, you understand the importance of ailments. And you also know as a homeopathic student, the same ailment, each of us
react
in a different manner. Okay? Now instead of me giving you only suppressed eruption as ailment, I am trying to go one step ahead and I am trying to tell you what will happen in psoriasis when the eruptions gets suppressed. Am I clear?
Yes.
See, this is something you should have a lot of clarity. Same element, all of them exposed to sun, okay, all of them get drenched in rain. Each individual, based on his susceptibility, reacts in a different way. I thought that clarity should happen. Okay, so what happens when the skin gets suppressed, or when the skin eruptions get suppressed in psoriasis? One question. And second question is, which are all the other remedies that come to your mind when we talk of ailments from suppressed eruptions? Antimprod, okay, good.
Cuprum, Apis.
Apis. Staphylococcus aureus, Dalcamara, Restorx, and you missed a very important remedy, sulfur. Okay. See, I will not go into the details of all these things because we will not finish one ailment. But I am making it clear to you that you should know that there are many remedies in our Materia Medica which has the same ailment. When I was a student like you, you were wondering, so many remedies having same ailment. But then after we passed out, we realized though the ailment is same, the manifestations are different. Now you are talking of metals. Just I'll give you a small example, I'll not go in depth. When you talk of metals, when you talk of cuprum, when you talk of zincum, now what happens in these remedies when the skin eruptions get suppressed?
Meningitis.
So they'll land up with nervous affections. They can either land up with meningitis or they can land up with
thrombosis.
So skin eruptions suppressed and nervous affections, the remedies will be mainly metals. Okay. Skin eruptions suppressed and then they go into a bad weakness. The only remedy we have is R-sulfamphir, ASL. I am just giving you some random examples. Okay. Now, we will come back to psoriasis. What will happen in psoriasis when the skin eruptions get suppressed? In a wild guess, what could happen? You can tell anything. Very good. One of your friends says respiratory affections. And to be more specific, sorainam will have cough. And sorainam is 3-mark remedy in your repertory, asthma from suppressed eruptions. Okay. And cough from suppressed eruptions. Good. In the respiratory, very good. And this is what your friend spoke. Now another very important thing. Okay. Very prominent in sorainam is. Can somebody quickly interpret this image? Very good paralysis. Can somebody go ahead and interpret this image? Good.
No.
Huh? Very good. What is it?
No.
Yeah, your friend has got it absolutely right. See now, the upper part is absolutely fine here. So, after suppressed eruption, if there is paralysis of the lower limbs, the only remedy in our materia medica is sorainam. Okay? I put in brackets only, meaning this is the only remedy in our materia medica which has paralysis of lower limbs after suppressed eruptions. Okay, if you are lucky, if you get somebody like this, we can think of sorainam. Moving ahead, headaches. Headache after suppressed eruptions. And not only headache, we saw under sphere of action. It's a very good remedy for diarrhea. So diarrhea, which comes after suppressed eruptions. Okay, and this your friend already told. So start off cough. So please capture all these things in your mind. And next class, when I talk to you about particular symptoms, when I talk to you about head, you know the one of the cause for headache in sorainam is suppressed eruptions. Am I clear? Okay. So now this, can somebody put in the question? Yeah. I'm happy. You're all glad. Good. Keep it up. And many of the the doctors who have watched the videos on the YouTube, more than appreciating my classes, they observed one very important thing. That the government college students are very interactive. This is a compliment for all of you. Many of the senior doctors have called me and told, I'm happy the way how the students answer. Okay, anyway, congratulations for that, and we'll get back. So you have put it right. Now this slide is about change in weather. Now, quickly, what comes to your mind? What remedies come to your mind? What comes to your mind means anything can come. So what comes to your mind when we talk of remedies, change of weather.
Bryonia.
Very good. What is bryonia? Other one is hepa.
Dalkamara.
Good. Tuberculum. Calica. Good. Beautiful. You have the list. Big list. Now, when all these remedies? When dalkamara, when bryonia, when calibi, when tuberculum, when sorainam, all these things play a very important role. See, many of us have no clarity, and why all of majority of us fail in our practice, homeopathic practice, is because there is no clarity. Any weather change, we prescribe dulcamara, and we are very optimistic that my remedy should work or my remedy will work, and you get disappointed. And ultimately, what is the statement you give? Homeopathy does not work. It reminds me of a small story. I mean, in school we were taught of this story. I don't know how many of you remember. Fox and the sour grapes. The hungry fox, I'll not tell you the entire story. Don't be very attentive. The hungry fox will be walking and it sees a grape tree. And it tries to jump and it tries to reach the grapes. Unfortunately, it could not reach the grapes. So what is the statement the fox gives? Fox says, grapes are not sweet, grapes are sour. And unfortunately, the same thing happens to us. We don't give the right similimum. We give a wrong remedy and we say, homeopathy is sour. And you know the fact, homeopathy is sweet and homeopathy works beautifully. But it should be based on the principle similia similibus curanda. So what I am trying to clarify here, any change of weather, dull camera will not work. Okay? Dull camera has its own change of weather element. So when weather from hot, when it becomes cold, then dull camera will come into picture. Now this season,
right,
we just passed the winter and we are in a very hot summer. And in clinics we get a lot of cases now, body pain, fever, cough. Now here the remedy is from cold to warm, change of weather, then the remedy, you have a list of remedies. You have got a bigger list in your repertoire. I have given you only the 3-mark remedies here. You will be seeing Brainia. See, this is wrong. I have just given you the remedies for change of weather. And I am going to the next level. From cold to warm, the remedy is Solana. From cold to warm, the remedy is Brainia. From cold to warm, the remedy is Tuberculum. From cold to warm, the remedy is Sulphur. Okay? Right? So, change of weather. Now, here again, when the weather changes, in a Solanum patient, what are the manifestations? That is very important. The manifestations could be again headache, or they can learn a bit diarrhea. And this is little different here. In Brainia, you will see more of constipation. In Solanum, you will see more of diarrhea. So, somebody comes to you tomorrow with a headache or with a diarrhea, and the cause, the attribute is change of weather. We can think of Solanum. We can think of Solanum. Any confusion? Clear? Okay. We'll go ahead because there are plenty of positive factors. Now we look at exposure to cold. Exposure to cold. Two things you have here. One will be skin eruptions and the other one will be headache. Headache or skin eruptions, which comes from exposure to cold. The remedy could be Solanum. And emotions, suppressed emotions. We are not talking of a single emotion. We are not talking of anger, we are not talking of sorrow, we are not talking of grief. Emotions in general. When the emotions get suppressed, what will happen in Solanum? How will the Solanum patient present to you? Again, here, if there is trembling, the only remedy in a Materia Medica, and that's why I am highlighting this point, if there is trembling of the whole body after any suppressed emotion, the only remedy that should come to your mind will be Solanum. So, what is this? Mental exertion, mental strain. You know many remedies. Can I have some remedies quickly? Very good. Lycopodium, good. Somebody
picric
there.
Acid.
Picric acid, calcarea, good. Keep it up. Now here, mental exertion. Ailments from mental exertion, lot of things can happen. So we will go a little quick here. Headache, we have seen in many of the ailments we have headache. Here, when they are mentally strained, they feel coldness of legs. Or coldness of feet, yes. Coldness of feet. When they are emotionally stressed. Or they can also have perspiration. Sweating. Or they can also feel weak, exhausted from mental exertion. Okay? Now lifting. Can I have few remedies?
Restox.
Sepia, good.
Ledum,
okay. Fine, Restox, Sepia. You got better remedies. As a final year student, you should also think of remedies like calcarea. Remedies like carbo animalis. What will happen in carbo animalis after lifting? What will happen in carbo animalis? In restors, you know what will happen?
Strains.
Huh? The muscles, the tendons, they can go into a strain. Okay. In carbo animalis. Carbon MLS, what is that? Somebody said something. What happens in carbon MLS? Or when do you think of calcarea in lifting? I mean, it's right. She's not sure,
weak,
but the answer is absolutely right. Weakness after lifting. only remedy in your material medical is carbon analysis. See, knowing answer right and you not being confident is also not a great thing, but good. I appreciate the fact you could think of weakness. Weakness from lifting is carbon analysis. Carbon analysis, not cargo weights. Carbon analysis. So you have to understand there is something called as carbon analysis also. Okay, now we'll get back. Calcareca, when calcareca? When calcareca? See, when you have a person who is restox, and you know, every time he comes to you with lifting or after lifting, you give restox. But you see him coming to you on and off, sir, I have pain, I lifted, I have pain, I lifted, you give restox and it feels better. So, E.A. Farrington in his lectures, he beautifully says, when you want to break this chain, he says, you calcareca. The restox patient whom you are giving and he feels better and he keeps coming to you very often. It's a clinical tip, I have taken it from beautiful Materia Medica. You should read this, E.A. Farrington, one of our favorite author, beautiful book. I'm not very sure about the comparative, but clinical Materia Medica is something I feel you should read, beautiful book. Okay. Now, ailments from thunderstorm, again, can I have some remedies?
Phosphorus.
Phosphorus, good. Where are the? Okay, Dalcamara. Where are the? Ranunculus bulbosa.
Rhododendron.
See, as a final year student, you should talk of some rare remedies also. That shows you are evolving. That shows you are also growing. Okay, rhododendron, ranunculus, Dalcamara, of course, and phosphorus. Okay. Now, what will happen is, Varayan, thunderstorm can cause fear. More than fear, one point I want to highlight here is, a patient becomes restless. When is the patient becoming restless?
Thunderstorm.
Before a thunderstorm. The only remedy you have in your repertory, restlessness before thunderstorm, is Varayan. Single remedy will be. Restlessness before. See, wherever I have written only, it means it is a single remedy. Okay? We'll go ahead. Again, ailments from strain, ailments from injuries, ailments from blows. And ailments from stormy weather. What is stormy weather? You can look at this picture. It will give you some insight. What do you understand by stormy weather?
Very windy.
Well, yeah, when you are more of lightning, thunder, dark clouds, and you definitely see the tree is
windy. Very.
Yeah, there's so much of strong winds. Right? So windy weather, dark clouds, when you have so much of thunder, winter and all, this combination is what we call it as stormy weather. So what we did in the second component, at the end of second component, what we did? We have looked at the ailments, fine, and we have also looked at what exactly is the result of this ailment in psoriasis. Any quick questions? Or is this clear? See, if you read the Materia Medica like this, it will definitely help you in your practice tomorrow. That's what I promised when I started class for you. The final year class should be more practically or clinically oriented. Whatever you are studying today here should get reflected in your practice tomorrow. Only and only then this exercise will be fruitful. Okay? Any questions? We'll go ahead. Okay. Now, what is it that I am trying to tell you here?
Massive.
Okay, good. You see a person here who is emaciated, beautiful. So what is it that I am trying to concentrate here?
Physical.
We are looking at the physical appearance of psoriasis. The physical constitution of psoriasis. How do they look physically? We have got beautiful remedies in our Materia Medica. Few are short, few are tall, few are fat, and few are thin. So psoriasis falls into this category. What is that category? Thin. Weak looking, thin people with lot of skin manifestation. Dirty skin, and you know they have eruptions, and they look lean and thin. 58 other remedies which are lean, thin.
Phosphorus. Tuberculinum. Tuberculinum.
Tuberculinum. Absolute red. Sickle comes beautiful. I didn't expect sickle, but one of the 3 marks in your repertory. Sickle, phosphorus, tuberculinum.
Calcarea phos.
Calcarea phos.
Iodum. Iodum.
Iodum. Plain iodum. You have something better. Beautiful, very good. Yeah, your friend has got. See, why I'm happy with sickle and why I'm happy with Ambra. These are our new remedies. I was talking to you about you upgrading yourself. Now, can you throw a little more information about Ambra Gasya? Ambra Gasya, absolutely right. I have something for you in Ambra. Beautiful, very good. We'll zero that particular point. Your friend has absolutely clear. Under lean people, lean constitution, you have a subrubric in your repertory, women. Under that, the only remedy you have is Ambra Gasya. But similarly, when you talk of sickle, sickle are again very lean, thin, scrawny. There are a lot of issues with circulation. Okay, so sickle come. You know tuberculum, you know iodum, you know sepia, you know sulfur, you know calcarea phos, you know calcarea silicata. They are all lean constitutions. Okay, so lean and thin persons with skin eruptions having filthy smell of the body. This is how it is given in our material medicals. Okay, now lean children. Which are the remedies? Calcarea silicata, calcarea phos, tuberculinum, sulfur, phosphorus. They could be lean children, and this is what your friend very rightly said. I am happy with that contribution. Lean women, and the remedy is Ambra Gasya. Beautiful remedy. Fine, Ambra Gasya. Okay. Any questions here? This slide speaks so much. The images, again, thanks to Google Images from where we have taken, it speaks so much. And we can remember better. Okay? Now, the last component for today. Now, before I take up the last component for today, ailments and pathogenesis. Second thing is ailments and its effects. Or the third thing we have combined there was the physical appearance. And the last thing here we will be discussing is what is character strength? See, we spoke of mind, okay? And in practice, the physical characteristic symptom will have its own place. Okay, they're very, very, very important. Physical generals. And many eminent doctors, they call it as syphilitic particulars, syphilitic characters. Okay, whatever term they give, keynote, characteristic, whatever it is, they are very, very important. Now, on top of this, can somebody quickly interpret? First question, is this characteristic? Now, what is she doing here? She is covering herself with
wool.
Wool, a fur cap, a fur coat. Now, is this common or is this uncommon? Simple interpretation.
Common in cold weather.
Okay, very good. One of your friends says it is common if it is winter. Correct. Chalikaldalli bechagottkontivi kambli raggu muffler and you know all these things. Now why I have put this under characteristic symptoms? Because soraina, even during peak summer, now Bangalore it is very hot, you all know. You get a patient to your clinic who is wearing all these things and coming to you. Now this is where you think of soraina. I'll share a case here. We had a case, a very nice case, and this gentleman was suffering with chronic rhinitis, chronic cold, chronic rhinitis. And what we observed here, see the beauty, what we observed in clinic is peak summer, he would come with all these things. okay, we are having fan, we are having you're feeling very hot. But this patient, even in the speak summary, comes covered himself with the way it is explained in your books, with a muffler and with a woolen sweater, and you know, and he's got a frequent cold. Okay, the remedy we gave him was
Solena.
Beautiful improved. And one more very important point I want to talk about this patient was, see, we have a huge park in our area, and this man would, when my wife and I, when we go for walking, no, some odd places he would stand like this only, still. 10 minutes, 12 minutes, we would go for a walk and we would come back. And again, he's in that position only. And you know, it's some kind of yoga, I'm not sure what it is. In some odd positions you would stand, seriously, like this only will be there. And he's like this only. No, no, see, why I'm, you are laughing and you are enjoying, but why I am giving you this example is, what did I tell you, as a homeopath, you should remember, when you enter homeopathy and when you are very serious about homeopathy, when you marry homeopathy, I mean, it's a beautiful thing, okay, you can marry the girl or boy of your choice, but what I am trying to tell you is, your commitment should be so much, even when you are working. Now I am doing my class here. You should think of something. So when my wife and me, you know, when we were walking, we were thinking, what is this man doing? Right? Now what is the rubric? Huh? I mean, see, it is not a disease state. Friend here, she is talking of a disease state. See, it's not going in a, I mean, it's not a disease. He's not going into some kind of catalepsy or some kind of, must be I gave a different, must be my acting, she thought must be as a patient, catalepsy, no, I'm not talking about that. 10 minutes will be like this, and next 10 minutes is in a different pose. So this we call it as, what is this?
Eccentric.
Yes, very good, eccentric. See, hundreds of people are walking on the road. Anybody did like this? See, you are doing exercise, agreed, you do exercise, no, you do dumbbells or you do stretches, fine, agreed. This is the same thing, you are doing the same thing, one day I saw, 2 days I saw, and every day is a different pose, and you will not move, you will not shake. And that's when I thought of rubric, eccentric. And he was the same man whom I had given Solena. You ready my point? So Solanum has, Solanum does not have eccentricity, but which is the remedy which is eccentric? Sulfur. And I was telling Dilip in the last class, or Pramod, or Nanin, somebody, they came and they were asking me, sulfur, I didn't give him sulfur because, you know, sulfur is hot, and we gave him Solanum. Because of this covering himself even in hot weather, and because of that, what we saw on road, he was doing some action, and this is an eccentric action which a normal person or which a normal walker or jogger will not do. Okay, eccentricity. Sulfur is very eccentric. Sulfur is very eccentric. Sulfur usually does all unwanted things. We have one more old man while walking on the BC. He keeps doing something at all. Something or this man is at least still. This, he his exercise is something very different. I thought, is he catching fish? Something or he'll be doing. He'll be putting a walkman and something on an order. Some leaf, some tree. Yeah, Martha Rapper. And he's not a small kid. If you are 6 years, still fine. You are 67, 68, and you are on the road, and so many people are watching you. And you know, it's all funny exercises, and nobody follows those exercises. I don't know the benefits of those exercises, but I feel somebody who is sane, who has got sense, will never follow those exercises. So that is sulfur. Eccentric. Very eccentric. So this gentleman, though it is a lady here, that patient, he was given Solanum and he beautifully improved. Okay? Improved with his cold. This thing continued. Fine? Okay? So, I have taken this from Alan's keynote, beautiful book, which you should buy at means you should have the symptoms on your tongue tip. Okay? I not read this, but the image will explain all these things happening in summer. Think of ceramic. See now, this is the beauty of homeopathy, and this is the beauty of characteristic symptoms. You need not take the entire case. You know something very striking. Referral number
153.
If I am right, PQRS. So these are all PQRS. You should not miss them. Okay, I'll give you a few more PQRS in psoriasis. Now this, can somebody interpret?
Yes.
Huh? Can somebody interpret this image? Now where should you target?
Center.
You should target here in the center. So when the indicated remedy fails, you know, if you remember reading psoriasis, when the indicated remedy fails, okay, for some reason, but see the beauty, they have given when the indicated remedy fails. Okay. So we don't know why the indicator remedy is failing. We'll have to trust. But the remedy is indicated. Don't tell me it is not indicated. So the remedy is indicated, and you know when the well-selected remedy failed to give relief or permanently improve, this was the thing. And from other books I have added, why it happens in psoriasis? In psoriasis it happens because of lack of reaction. The body is not reacting. The vital force is so low, it is not reacting to the indicated remedy. In such cases, you can think of psoriasis. So, can I quickly have some more remedies here from your side? In this situation, which are the other remedies that should come to your mind? When indicated remedy fails, I'm sorry, I don't know. It might be there, I don't
know.
Anti-yeah, which are those remedies? Don't tell me all anti-mesmeric remedies. Okay, good. Good thought. Okay, medulinum is again an anti-mesmeric remedy, but it will not come here. Can somebody help here? Okay, sulfur could be one. Tuberculinum, okay, chalo, good, tuberculinum. I thought there will be a big mess, at least from the other students here. You took the compliment very seriously, and you are feeling hurty, and you are feeling anyway. See, there are a few. There are some 13 remedies. That's what I was thinking. You know, one is alumina, carbogas, carcinosin, laurocerosis, opium, sulfur, tuberculin. Tube sulfur, we got it. I'm not going to the details of all these remedies, but laurocerosis, the rare remedy, when an indicated remedy is not affecting, especially in heart or respiratory affections. Somebody has got cardiac or respiratory affection, and if you are given a remedy which is indicated, and that patient is not responding the way you expect him to respond. I hope I'm clear. Then you can think of laurocerosis. Only in respiratory and cardiac affections. Okay? Yeah, now this quickly. What would be the PQRS?
Offensive.
Good. Can somebody go ahead?
Carry on leg.
Offensive. Any discharge in psoriasis. Let it be from nose, let it be from ears, eyes, any hole that you can remember or you can think of, there will be discharges, and the discharges are offensive. Offensive like what? See now, can somebody quickly interpret this?
Even washing will not.
Even after washing. Even after bathing, see the tragedy. Now go back to skin, go back to the sebaceous secretion, go back to the lymphatic system, and now you interpret. Materia will be beautiful to understand. Okay? So that's where your sphere of action and pathogenesis help you to reason why all these things are happening in the drug picture. Okay? In spite of washing. The child stinks. Okay? Don't blame the mother. Must be mother did not wash him properly. In spite of mother giving him a very nice wash, he continues to stink. Sorry. Okay? So now, this is very, very important. Carrion light. Now, what is carrion light? Carrion. Carrion. You know it is carrion, but how will you know it is carrion? How will the patient come and tell you? See, these are all English words, fruit abroad. We are poor country, India, right? And we don't know English. None of our patients know English. They'll not come and tell you, doctor, I have smell and the smell is like kerium. Give me sorainam. Nobody will come and ask. So, but locally, or what does it mean, kerium like?
Spoiled.
Okay, spoiled. Now, the beautiful thing I can give you here is, some animal died,
decomposed,
and that animal goes into decay. You would have seen this, now you remember, roadside, somewhere something has died and then it goes into decay, it rots. And that's when you get a kind of a smell, and that smell is kerium. Imagine the plight of sorainam patient, the perspiration of sorainam, the leucorrhea of sorainam, the diarrhea, the menses, they all stink. Like the lady might be very embarrassed to tell, that way some animal dies, no, and then it decays, and you would have smelled that kind of a decayed smell. That is the smell my sweat is. Okay? Now, this is very, very prominent in sorainam. Don't miss this. Okay, we have got a lot of remedies which has offensive discharges, but to this extent it is sorainam. Am I clear? Okay. Now going ahead. Now this somebody quickly. Very good, beautiful. See, quick is that quick, beautiful. Loss of appetite. Very good. Now can somebody complete this sentence in sorainam? No, that I'll complete later. Good. No issues, no problem. Good. At least some interaction, some noise. I'm happy. Yes? Good. She was talking about something, Shilpan. And what was that? Loss of appetite. Or want of appetite. Yes or tappu illa or not? Okay. Now, loss of appetite. Now, want of appetite. Want of appetite after an acute illness. Okay? How do you interpret this? Child had fever or child had some acute illness, and after that acute illness, the child has lost appetite. Remember, it could be a beautiful clinical tip tomorrow in your practical life. So after an acute episode, the child has lost appetite. After an episode of an acute illness, the child loses appetite. Okay? Lack of vital reaction, you saw that. Frustration after acute disease when appetite will not return. My child has a very good appetite, doctor. I never had issues with his appetite. But after the pyrup fever, okay, he has lost appetite. And appetite is so stubborn, it is not coming back. You give a dose of sorainam and he will get back to his original appetite. There are very strong statements, verified statements, and they are very, very easy to remember and easy to apply. Don't miss. They are sure, short remedies. Okay. Now I will come to your friend's point. Okay, now we will also finish this skin, a very important remedy. Yen madutha skin mele, it will cause
dryness,
it will cause eczema, and discharges, scaly discharges. See, eruptions disappear in summer and again return in winter. Eruptions disappear in summer. Summer have no issues. But once the winter starts, again I start with eruptions. Easy to practice. Sorainam. Okay? Yeah, this somebody can interpret. Yeah, okay, good. Spring, goggles, girl, pink. Yes, good third. I have always told when I have given you an open question, I should have the guts to accept the answers. Yes? Yeah, somebody says red flowers, yes, good. Yes, sky, beautiful, good. But what is it in toto that you want to tell here?
Happy.
Yeah, very good. The child is happy. Good, beautiful. Child is happy. Okay. Now I'll give you a small case here. Small practical situation. So that you understand this characteristic symptom better. We have many intelligent mothers who come and tell, "Doctor, my son or my daughter, she is eating very well today." Good. Let her eat. What is wrong? No, doctor. Every time I have observed, I have seen that if this guy starts eating more now, this is a small indication for me that he will fall sick in next 24 or 48 hours. Or the mother would have observed, the child is very active, jumping, gimping and all. Doctor, I have seen with my son, next 24 hours, next 48 hours, he is definitely going to fall sick. This is the situation. Now this is what you have in Swayam. What is it?
Unusually
well, a day before an attack. Okay? Unusually well, a day before an attack. All given in alliance. And you have to be master of alliance. Master of alliance. Minimum, you should know alliance. It's a small book. Minimum. And beyond it is your capacity. You read Kent's, or you read Clark, you read Boring, it's all higher level books. Minimum, where it is, which line it is, that particular, that sure you should be. Okay? Swayam. Feels unusually well a day before attack. Now, your friend was talking of hunger. Now, this is the hunger thing. Now, what is it that you have in Swayam related to hunger?
Hungry person.
Huh? Okay, intolerance. See, it is not loss of appetite.
Excessive.
Swayam. Okay. See, there's something very important. Hunger gets up at night and eats. Hunger gets up at night. Madhyaratri yavaglo, he would have had his dinner. In spite of that, he gets up at night. Madhyaratri eddu utteshu anta uta madodu. There are many remedies. One remedy is Swayam. When I say many remedies, what is the next question expected? Which are all the other remedies? Yes. Which are all the other
remedies? Sulfur.
Okay, sulfur. Huh? Iodine in general, no problem. Iodine, but getting up in midnight and eating. One more remedy you should remember is lycopersion. China. Okay? China. Sinkona. They get up at night from hunger and they start eating. Okay? Like how Sinkona, sulfur, Swayam. Hungry in middle of night must have something to eat. Yeah. Last one or two and we'll stop. What is this I'm trying to concentrate here? Yes? You see a man burping. Okay, I don't have the image. Does that hurt his burping? Okay, eructations. Right? Now, if I put Swayam eructations under characteristic, then there should be something special about the eructations. What is it? It is something like arnica. It is something like antimonium fluoride. I know, Swayam is not over. So I am giving you the
loud.
Which remedies have loud eructations? Don't name the person. I am asking you the remedies. They are loud, no? And they would have eaten in this room. They would have worked here and you can listen it in the Avagaman. Oh, that guy is burping. Great. Loud eructations. My wife was telling this. Especially in China or Japan, eructation is a compliment to the lady who was cooked. I don't know which country. We'll take it as Japan, right? I'm not very sure about this thing. So when you eat and you burp, no? So it's a compliment to the lady who was cooked. Yes, your food was tasty and I enjoyed. So I'm burping. But here it is not loud in Swayam. Which remedy says loud? We are talking of loud, like something explosive. Which is that remedy? No problem. Which is that remedy? Loud, like a volcano or something, you know, erupting out. Not like volcano, may not be that loud, but it's a simile, it's a comparison. Loud eructations. One remedy is asafoetida. A rare remedy, but you should remember. You have studied assembly. Good. You have studied? Yeah, no problem. We will not go into the details, but remember asafoetida. Okay, remember asafoetida. So here, erectation testing slide, testing like rotten eggs. That's why I gave you, which remedy?
Arnica.
That's why I gave you antimonium prudum. They both have this, two top remedies. Arnica, at least Arnica. Don't forget, erectation like rotten eggs. So when eggs are spoiled now, you get that smell. That is the kind of smell his burp is tasting, right? And again, one classical symptom of psoriasis. What is this?
Headache.
What relieves headache in psoriasis? Yes, headache, always hungry during headaches and they feel better by eating. Now which are the other remedies?
Anacardium.
Anacardium. Now, how is anacardium different from psoriasis? How is anacardium different from psoriasis?
Anacardium has gastric headaches.
Yes. Anacardium is a general ameliorating factor. Any damn thing in anacardium is better by eating. We are talking of a particular thing. Good. But anacardium is there in your repertory. 2 marks. The only 3 marks remedy in your repertory, headache better by eating, is sepia. Headaches better by eating is sepia. Okay. You also have psoriasis. Now we are talking of the aversions and what Sorana will not like. Sorana will not like pork, he will not like cooked food, he will not like tobacco, though he is a chili patient, he will not like
hotness.
Okay? Now what he likes? He likes more of alcohol, he likes more of cold things. You see something fishy here?
Chili patient.
Chili patient. Is a chili patient. Good. Yeah. But he has an aversion to warm. Psoriasis is a chili patient, but he has desire to cold. Which is the other remedy which comes very close?
Phosphorus.
Okay, yes. More than phosphorus. Good.
Elapse.
Yes. More than elapse. This kind of a combination. Though chili, they are not like hot. Okay, I mean, good thinking. Ignitia. Why ignitia? Very good. I'm happy you thought of ignitia, but that's not what I wanted. Could be ignition, beautiful, good. I'm happy you are at least thinking. Though it's time for lunch and I know many of you can't tolerate hunger, you're still thinking. That's a beauty. That's the beauty. But the remedy I wanted here is silesia. Silesia is again a chilly patient, but likes
cold
and has an aversion to warm. Likes warm. Okay, good. And he also has disease for citrus. Okay. Probably the last characteristic symptom and then we'll stop. What is it that I'm trying to tell or what is it that I've missed in psoriasis when it comes to the characteristic symptoms? What is it that we're trying to see here? It's a beautiful remedy for asthma. Asthma. Okay. Asthma, we have got many remedies with wonderful results. But what is special in psoriasis? Asthma?
Better
by lung. Asthma
better
by lung down?
With
extended
arms.
With his arms?
Stretch.
So tomorrow you have somebody coming to your clinic and they give you this symptom. You'll have to be very particular. We ask them, what do you do when you are wheezing? Which position you are better? There are different questions. We are running short of time. Can you quickly tell me which are the other remedies which has a characteristic position when it comes to asthma?
So, bending backwards.
Bending backwards like this. Which is the remedy?
Hepar.
Bending it back. The remedy is Hepar. Bending it forward.
Kali.
The remedy could be ours. Or the better remedy is Kali.
Kalika.
Okay. And asthma better sitting erect.
Arsal.
Again you have asked your colleagues here. Asthma better by standing? Yes, asthma. He can't breathe and he stands and he feels better. Asthma better by?
Cannabis.
Cannabis sativa. Very good. Cannabis sativa. Cannabis sativa. Asthma better by dancing?
Sepia.
Don't do ignitia.
Sepia.
The remedy is sepia. Asthma better by dancing. Okay. See, you'll be shocked. This is how the patient will come and tell. Where a lady, where we had used CPR. The mother, the moment the girl has breathing now, she'll put some music and the girl dances and she feels better. The remedy is CPR. Okay. Asthma better by standing, the remedy is
cannabis.
Better by bending head back, the remedy is HEPA. Better by bending head forward, the remedy is Kali. Better by knee chest position. Very good, Medarrhino. These are all remedies as a budding homeopath, as a promising homeopath, you should know. If you read Kent Cesar's now, I visited some patient and the patient was in this position. Kent did not ask any other question. Kent just prescribes and they come out. Kent, if you read lectures, he says, the moment I entered the patient room, it was smelling so bad. And you know, I gave arsenic or I gave soranum. And patient beautifully improved. This is why you should read Kent's. It goes in narrative form. And you never ever forget if you read drugs from Kent's, unless you have some serious memory issues. Beautifully written. Many of us look at the volume and we run away. But you don't know, this is our investment for your practice. Patient comes in the same language at all and it strikes, yes, I read this somewhere. And you open Kent's and you read and you know, you give a remedy. Fine? It works wonderfully. So asthma, this is what I was trying to tell you. So the last component for the day, we discussed the characteristic symptoms of psoriasis. Hope you have done justice. Hope things are clear. Okay? Now tomorrow or in the last class or in the next class when we speak of psoriasis, which should be the last class of psoriasis, we'll be focusing entirely on the particular symptoms. Now, how do you study particular symptoms? Many of the times, the boring part of Materia Medica, somehow mind you'll understand. I have many seniors and you know my class is open, anybody can come. They ask me, sir, what are you doing? I tell them I am doing first mentals. They all get excited and they come. And next class when I'm carrying my laptop to the class, they'll ask, sir, what are you doing? I say first particular. Particular, sir. Okay, you go, sir. We are not joining you. So, you know, particulars, many times we neglect. Now, why do we neglect? Because we don't have a planned methodology to study particulars. Particulars are also equally important. Now, how do you study particulars? That's a question. Now, how do we make particular symptoms interesting? How do you make particular symptoms practical and valid? Becomes very, very difficult. Now, how do we make it interesting? How do you make it interesting?
Apply the pathogenesis. Pathogenesis.
Okay, so to understand particulars, you will have to know sphere of action and pathogenesis. You should also know the elements form. And last thing you should know is you should know the characteristic symptoms. So a combination of pathogenesis, elements form, characteristic symptom, and very important, you miss this. Knowledge of all subjects. Knowledge of anatomy, physio, pathology, surgery, OPG, medicine, all that makes particular symptoms, class on particular symptoms, very interesting. Now the idea of me giving all this is, not for you to only listen, for you to go back home and read and prepare yourself for the particulars that we'll be discussing in the next class. So that it will be again very interactive and it will be more practical. So please go back, read sphere of action, pathogenesis, whatever I did today. And of course this, which you already know, we'll try to use this and make the class more interesting. One last time before we close, any questions? Anything you would like to ask? Contribute, something I missed that you would like to add? Nothing? All clear.